Hi guys, this is Angie and welcome to my Sales Burn, the series in which I go through every game I've probably bought on some kind of sale. I'm not sure because, seriously, I have no idea how I got them. So either way, this week I wanted to show you Dogsled Saga. It's a racing slash management game about a dogsledding. You are a musher, I think that's the term, and you start a game having a small shack and no dogs whatsoever. You get a small number of money and you are able to buy your first dogs and take part in the first race. But as the game progresses, you get to access more and better stuff and also dogs. But the racing is more complicated than just letting your dogs take your sled away. You need to manage food thrown to the dogs, otherwise they might get tired and slow you down. You need to watch out for the obstacles on the road and you need to keep in mind the weather. Dogs can have preferred kinds of weather, during which they will perform better than other, or it will just make them happy. There also can be other things that make them happy. Winning, getting more fame, seeing their opponents, or just petting. Because yes, you can pet your dogs in this game, and they are so happy when you do that. But like I said, this is not only a racing game, this is also a management game. So you'll have to manage your pack of dogs. You'll have to see which of them are better or certain positions, if they are better in the middle, in the front, or on the wheel, if they like certain things, and if they have certain talents, or maybe some disadvantages. During the course of the game, you will learn what those disadvantages do. And at the start of each race, you'll be able to see what is the possibility to get this advantage or disadvantage during the race. When you are racing, you also have to take under the consideration the type of weather. Because like I mentioned, some dogs perform better in certain kinds of weather, but some do not. And depending on this, you can see how difficult it will be for them to race. It is shown in the certain levels of difficulty. It goes up to dangerous, and in that level, the dog will be constantly tired and you will have to throw them a treat almost all the time. It can be very difficult for you as you'll probably have more dogs. As for the races, at first you'll only race with three dogs attached to your sled. But the higher you'll get in the league, the more dogs will be pulling your sled and automatically the race will be faster. So you'll have to be more observant of what is happening. But going back to the management part, you can decide which dogs are taking part in a race, which are resting or are being trained. You can also decide if you are going to sell a dog or buy a new one, or maybe breed two dogs you already have, but you will have to keep in mind that that will disable one of them for a few weeks at least. And then you will have a puppy, which is mighty cute, but useless. You also have to manage your budget because once a month you have to pay, let's say, rent. It is amount of money you're paying for each dog, for having this shed, for any employees you'll have, because at some point you will hire employees to train your dogs when you are racing. And by winning the races, you are earning this money. If you have anything left, then you can think about investing into either your shed or in your employees. But don't worry, as you'll get more famous because of your dogs, because your dogs can do tricks during the race, and when they are doing tricks, they are getting fame. And once your dog is famous, automatically your team is more famous, and that brings sponsors to your team. You can have a sponsorship for your sled, so it will behave better in bad conditions, for rope, so the dogs won't tangle during the race and won't slow down. Or you can get a discount from them so your rent will be lower. All of those can be very helpful during your sledding career. I have to admit, although this game seems like a pretty simple concept, there's a lot to it. And I think part of the fun that I had with it was discovering some of this stuff. Like, for example, once my dog started getting slow during a race, I learned that it has some kind of a disadvantage that under certain conditions make them slow down. There are also different kinds of dog you can have. You can have huskies, labs, bernards. I could talk about this game for hours, telling you all my adventures I had with it. But I highly recommend you check it out yourself. So there is a link in the description and I'll hope you'll check it out. But for now, thank you guys so much for watching and I hope I'll see you next time. Bye!